India has successfully tested a hypersonic system that could pave the way for the development of a hypersonic weapon. The Hypersonic Technology Demonstrator Vehicle, HSTDV, developed by Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, was launched at 11:03 hours on the 7th of September, 2020. DRDO is the research and development arm of India's military. Viewers may note that India has carried out an initial test of the HSTDV on the 12th of June, 2019. The latest test was conducted from Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Launch Complex at Wheeler Island off the coast of Odisha. India Prime Minister tweeted, "Congratulations to @DRDO_India for successful flight of hypersonic test demonstration vehicle today. The scramjet engine developed by our scientist helped the flight achieve a speed 6 times the speed of sound. Very few countries have such capability today. Currently, only 3 countries, Russia, the US, and China, have successfully tested this kind of system." The timing of this test is interesting, since it comes at a time when India and China are involved in an increasingly bitter border row, which escalated after the deadly June's clash. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how India has successfully gotten into the Hypersonic Weapons League with Hypersonic Technology Demonstrator Vehicle. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently 3 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. The first is using a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engine can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missiles to reach hypersonic speeds. The scramjet engine can power a hypersonic cruise missile. The second is through the use of ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missile. As the name suggests, this kind of missile is ballistic in nature, but it's launched from the air, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, which are launched from the land or sea-based platforms. The third is using HGV, or hypersonic glide vehicle. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile or an aircraft, where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and glides back to Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. The glide vehicle could be powered or unpowered. India's HSTDV uses this method and deploys a powered glider. India launched the hypersonic glide vehicle using its proven solid-fueled rocket motor. The HGV separated from the carrier rocket at an altitude of 30 kilometers. The air intake of HGV opened as planned, and it continued on its desired flight path at a velocity of 6 times the speed of sound. In other words, nearly 2 kilometers per second for more than 20 seconds. The scramjet engine performed in a textbook manner, and several critical events like fuel injection and auto ignition of scramjet were validated. It's to be noted that the parameters of the launch and glide vehicle, including the scramjet engine, were monitored by multiple tracking radars, electro-optical systems, and telemetry stations. Indian Navy warships were also deployed in the Bay of Bengal to monitor performance during the cruise phase of the hypersonic vehicle. India Defense Minister Rajnath Singh congratulated DRDO for achieving the milestone. Secretary DDR&D and Chairman DRDO congratulated all the scientists and support staff for their contributions, improving highly complex air-breathing hypersonic technology. Countries like Russia, China, and the US have been developing sophisticated layered air defense. These systems are difficult for traditional aircraft and missiles to penetrate. This is where hypersonic weapons come in. Their extreme speed and ability to fly in unpredictable paths give them a high probability of penetrating the air defenses. They'll be very hard to track, let alone intercept. It's to be noted that traditional ballistic missiles, like American Minuteman III, Russian Sarmat, or Indian Agni missiles, also reach hypersonic speed when they descend down on the target. But they follow a predictable, predefined parabolic path, which could lead to possible interception by anti-ballistic missile defense systems. The characteristic of hypersonic weapons makes it suitable for neutralizing well-defended strategic military assets. These weapons may also be used in neutralizing incoming enemy missiles, where they'll be used as interceptors. India has two hostile nuclear-armed neighbors, China and Pakistan. Keeping this in view, India is taking the right step. Russia is leading the hypersonic weapon space as of now. It's claimed that it's already fielded a hypersonic missile named Kinzhal, also a hypersonic boost glide vehicle named Avangard. China is thought to be pursuing hypersonic weapons as well. It's shown off mock-ups of its road mobile DF-17 as part of the October 2019 celebrations commemorating the 70th anniversary of the founding of the People's Republic of China. It's to be noted that America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report has stated that the U.S. currently lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats. The United States is working on multiple approaches for developing its own hypersonic weapon and may have a working prototype by 2021. India's missile program is one of the most advanced in the world. It has several kinds of missiles, short, medium, and long-range ones. The Agni 5 missile is the longest-range weapon, with an officially stated range of 3,100 miles, or 5,000 kilometers, but an actual estimated range of more than 5,100 miles, or 8,200 kilometers. On March 27, 2019, India even conducted an anti-satellite missile, ASAT, test. Till then, only three countries, the US, Russia, and China, have demonstrated this kind of capability. The test was also conducted by Defense Research and Development Organization. The anti-satellite missile knocked out a satellite, which was in low Earth orbit at an altitude of 186 miles, or 300 kilometers. India already has a homegrown two-layer BMD, ballistic missile defense. India's indigenously designed BMD system was successfully tested on May 15, 2016. The two-tiered BMD system consists of the PAD, Prithvi Air Defense, which will intercept missiles at exo-atmospheric altitudes of 50 to 80 kilometers or 31 to 50 miles, and the AAD, Advanced Air Defense missile, for an interception at endo-atmospheric altitudes of up to 30 kilometers or 19 miles. Adding hypersonic weapons in its arsenal will surely add another dimension to India's military capability and enhance its deterrence capacity. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.